Hey everyone, I hope you guys are doing absolutely well and welcome back to another video and welcome back to my channel. So this video is going to be very interesting and it is going to be about a very basic topic about KDP low and no content publishing books. It is going to be about KDP low and no content book title and subtitle. Yes, title and subtitle are the key ingredients of any of the book that you will be publishing on KDP. And in this video, we are going to take a look at some of the important aspects as what is something that you must do for your book title and subtitle, and which are all the key things that you must avoid when you are publishing your low and no content books on Amazon KDP. Yes, I'm pretty sure this is going to be real interesting. So make sure that you watch the video till the end. And in case if you're new to the channel, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and hit that bell notification. I really appreciate that. And with that said, I'll see you on the other side of the video wherein we'll talk about KDP book title and subtitle must do and must avoid things. All right. So let's first talk about what are the must-do things whenever you are publishing your book on Amazon KDP. Okay, so far, based on my experience with Amazon KDP, this is what I have learned. Okay, so the very first thing that we have to do is that for a specific keyword which we are targeting for our book, we have to make sure that the main keyword is something that comes in the title of the book. Yes, we have to make sure that for whichever the keyword we want to rank our book, whichever the keyword we have kind of considered as the primary keyword for our book, that keyword should be part of our book. And let me show that to you with an example. Okay, so let me switch back to Amazon. Okay, I have already opened Amazon.com. I have selected the zip code as US zip code so that we'll be able to see the correct results. And okay, let's say for example you're creating a book for YouTube planning book for kids. Okay, so the things that we have to take into consideration is that the title of your book must contain that specific keyword. So yes, if at all there is a very low competition for that keyword, and the chances are very high that your book will show up on the first page of Amazon bookshelf. So this is the first key lesson that I have learned in my publishing journey, that whatever the primary keyword that we are targeting for that specific book, it must show up in the title of the book. That probably enhances the probability of showing up that book on the first page of Amazon bookshelf. Yes, so that is one important aspect of it. Then the second most important lesson that I have learned out of my publishing journey is that make your title and subtitle as simple as that. Somebody looking at your book title and subtitle, it should not feel like that this is something that is flooded with the different set of keywords. You need to make it more realistic. And at the same time, you should try to cover as much keywords as you can possibly cover, but it shouldn't kind of give an impression that you are kind of trying to flood it with n number of keywords. Make it more realistic, make it more simplistic. The more simple, the better. So yes, that is the another key lesson that we have to kind of take into consideration when we are writing our title and book title and the subtitle, sorry. When we're writing the title and subtitle of our book. Yes, and another most important thing is that whatever you have on your book cover, make sure that it is appearing in your title and subtitle. What I generally prefer is that whatever text that is showing up on my book cover, I generally try to put it in the title part of it, and which is basically going to be the primary keyword that I am targeting for. So this gives us one benefit that during the review process, I never get my book rejected due to this reason, saying that whatever is there on my book cover, it's not appearing on my title or subtitle. So yes, it's kind of give us a guardrail that our book is not getting rejected during the KDP review process. Yes, so these were the key lessons about title and subtitle. Now, If at all you have started your KDP publishing journey, so you must have been familiar with this KDP university that we have. And over here, there are a few important lessons that has already been mentioned. So as a new publisher, it would definitely be a good idea to kind of go through this once so that you are sure that what is something that needs to be done and what is something that you must not do. Okay, and about the book title, that is another important thing that we have to consider is that we have to make sure that we are not using anything that is trademarked. Yes, about trademark thing, we'll cover it in a separate video, but take it into consideration that we are not using any terminology which is kind of marked as a trademark term. Otherwise, there are high chances that it can kind of affect our KDP account as well, and our KDP account might get suspended or terminated. Okay. With that said, let me kind of quickly have a walkthrough of what is something that has been mentioned on KDP University about the book titles, the things that we have to do and we shouldn't. Okay, so the first thing is that we have to enter your title exactly as it is being read on the cover of your book. Nothing more, nothing less. Yes. So this is something that the point I already told you, which basically helps us to not have our book getting rejected during the review process. And then make sure that our book title is exactly the same for paperback, hardcover, or ebook version, so that you know it would be easy for having the books linked with one another. And some important things that we shouldn't be doing is that we shouldn't be adding any unauthorized reference to other book titles or other authors. Yes, this is something that as a new author or an established author as well, we must avoid if you want to be in the KDP business for a longer run. Then, as I said, we have to kind of avoid using any trademark term in our title or subtitle. Then another most important thing is that generally we have to avoid kind of using any reference to any sales rank. Like we shouldn't be using best selling logbook or best selling YouTube planning book for kids. This is something that we must avoid. And then we must also avoid any reference to advertisements or promotions like free or so, those kind of terms we should not be using in our title at all. Then yes, this one is, I don't know who will be doing like this, but yes, only punctuation we should be avoiding in our title. Then these are some of the terms that we must be avoiding. Then repeating keywords is something that is not encouraged by KDP. So we have to make sure that we're not repeating the keywords, and we should try to make it more simplistic as much as we can. So these are the do's and don'ts about book title. And let's talk about subtitle. So what KDP says is that a subtitle is an optional secondary title that will kind of contain any additional information that you want to give about your book, right? So this is something, it's an optional thing. And what I have generally seen based on my experience is that like for ranking of the book, what matters is whatever you have used mainly in the title. If at all some high ticket keywords that you have used in subtitle, but I have seen that that is something that is kind of not getting that much traction as compared to whatever is there in subtitle. So yes, subtitle should be used as an additional information that would kind of give a more insight about your book by just looking at the title and subtitle. And yes, as we already know that title and subtitle must be 200 characters or less. So what I generally prefer is the lesser is better and more simple is more realistic and much better. So then what it says that the subtitle should also be adhering to the same guidelines as we had seen for title. So yes, all these points are equally applicable for subtitle as well. And here there are some few examples that has been given for what should be the subtitle that should be. And if you are using a subtitle, so you might have generally seen that a colon is automatically getting appended by Amazon itself. So you don't need to have the colon added explicitly. So yes, these are the kind of a very basic things that you have to consider about your KDP, no and low content books. Whenever you're publishing that, you have to make sure that this is something that you're doing for your title, and you're must avoiding the don't do things for your title as well as subtitle. So yes, this was a kind of a very basic thing that I felt that every KDP publisher, even if he is a new or even if he or she is an established publisher, this is something that those are the core ingredients and the core components that everyone has to take care to be in the KDP journey for a longer term. I hope this video was pretty useful. I'll be coming up with more such useful videos about KDP and different aspects of KDP book publishing. So in case if you like this kind of content, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and hit that bell notification. I would really appreciate that. If you like the content of this video, make sure that you give a thumbs up. If you didn't like, you can hit the dislike button as well. And whatever your thoughts are, whatever your feedback is, you can write that down in the comment section. I would love to read that. And thank you very much for your time watching the video. I really appreciate that, and I'll see you in the another video. Till the time, happy publishing.